Hey, how are you? It's good to see you. I hope you're doing well. Thanks for stopping by and joining me. I'm going to be doing a humble review of Young's Double Chocolate Stout beer, which I've never had before. I first wanted to apologize to some folks out there who suggested some of the beers that I went and picked up a couple weeks prior to this video. I drank a couple of them at home, shared some of them, so unfortunately I won't be doing reviews of them. I'm gonna have to go out and pick them up again. I do want to say though that they were very enjoyable. Thank you again. But like I said, I will be picking up some more of your suggestions and the beers that I previously picked up to try to do some more proper reviews. And of course, I want to apologize for not doing more beer reviews. Trying to make more effort to put those into my rotation more often. Also going to be opening up this game for the PS3, Fallout 3 New Vegas. It is the add-on Ultimate Edition. I'm not sure if it's a standalone. I believe it is. Meaning, I'm not sure. Oh no, it is add-on. That's what I thought. For Fallout 3. I've never played New Vegas, and I'll be putting this into my gaming rotation after I open up and play the original Fallout 3. This is my own personal lunchbox. This is not the one that I'm giving away. I'm going to be opening this in this video. Those of you that have, like me, have never seen what's inside of it and stuff. Again, my thanks to the anonymous person that donated these. I guess you could say. My thanks to you. You know who you are. And that's why I'm giving away the other ones. So, first things first, before we open up our beer, is to do our exercises. We all know in this day and age how important it is that we make sure we get our exercise in. Now, our little guy here is just going to direct you on what you need to do. You can raise your arms up if you want. Well, you can stand up, you can just sit there, or you can watch, because you'll burn calories just watching. It's true. Alright, so, ready to get started? Alright, ready? One. Two. Three. Good job. Four. Even if you're watching, I can tell you're watching intently. Five. Six, you can do it. Seven. Eight. Nine, and one more. Give it all you got. 10, good job. Give yourself a round of applause. All right. So let's check this beer out. Young's Double Chocolate Stout. Pure Luxury. Established 1831. Ale with natural chocolate flavor added. Chocolate malts and real dark chocolate are combined with Young's award-winning rich dark ale to craft a satisfyingly indulgent but never overly sweet experience. alcohol by volume of 5.2%. Product of England, brewed and bottled by Wells and Young's Brewing Company Limited, Bedford, United Kingdom. Imported by the Bellicus, or by Bellicus Marketing Incorporated, College Station, Texas. And they have a website, wellsandyoungs.co.uk. So, let's open this up. And of course, for those of you that enjoy the bottle cap tapping, clicking, whatever you want to call it. And of course, if you don't drink beer, that's quite all right. You can drink soda, water with lemon, or nothing at all and just chill out, whatever it might be. I know some folks just enjoy listening while they're working and or playing a game or drawing. That's fine too. As long as you get to chill out, that's all that matters. It's not always about experiencing ASMR, it's just chilling out, no, relaxing. I still need to do a bottle cap tapping, clicking only video, as well as a beer suds only video. All right. Let's give this a pour, shall we? I want you to just enjoy the sound of those suds. Just pour a little bit more in there. Some left in the bottle. Alright. Let's get those suds up there for you. Hoping you can hear that. so you can tell how dark it is. It's pretty much what you're seeing is pretty much the same thing I'm seeing. It's got a, of course, a nice head. Most stouts, porters usually do, that I've experienced. Now it's got that classic stout malt aroma. And I can smell the chocolate, the hint of chocolate's not very overpowering, that's for sure. It's not very bitter. Smooth, and there is some dark chocolate, hint of dark chocolate again. Doesn't seem to be quite as powerful of a chocolate beer as one of the previous ones I've had. I'd say it's a nice blend. It's a mild chocolate flavor for sure. It's subtle. But nice stout. You know, not smooth and not too bitter and nice malt flavor. Yeah, I'd give this a little bitters, or maybe like that dark chocolate bitter sitting on the roof of my tongue after, but definitely a nice blend of stout, typical stout malts, and chocolate. Like I said, the chocolate is not very strong or overpowering. So I'd give this a good 3.5 stars. I give it 4, maybe. I don't normally look the beers up on Beer Advocate, for example, to see what other folks, because I don't want to set myself up with any kind of expectation. That's pretty good. That's good. I would drink that again. And it's room temperature. All right, so what should we open up first? New Vegas. I guess it makes sense to open up the lunchbox first. So this is an actual lunchbox. There's the handle and the clasp, the closure. PlayStation 3, Fallout 3. For those of you who don't know what type of game this is, it's a post-apocalyptic game. It is the spiritual successor of the game titled Wasteland that came out for the Commodore 64 back in the mid-80s. And I owned a Commodore 64 when it first came out. My oldest brother purchased it for us one Christmas morning, and it was the most glorious Christmas ever, without a doubt. Of course, you know, our son being born in his first Christmas is a real close second, but nothing passes the Commodore 64, I'm sorry. I'll probably sell my son for a new Commodore 64. But in all seriousness though, this Commodore 64, that was just amazing. The graphics are dated, but it was a great time because gaming was new pretty much. So, but anyway. This is first person. It also has third person perspective. And you control a character who survived a nuclear fallout, nuclear war. There's different factions. You have lots of dialogue, character interactions, and it's not quite as free roam as maybe Oblivion, but it's still pretty expansive. I'm not sure how many gaming hours there are that you could put into it. I've never finished Fallout 3. I'm going to start putting it in my rotation, like I said, and try to play it at least, you know, twice a month, if not more, along with Skyrim and, of course, Minecraft. Those are pretty much going to be the mainstays of my ASMR gaming. Alright, so, I'm getting old here. I am old. It says on the back, you can see here the design, we have Fallout Boy. It's kind of like a retro feel. It's a futuristic slash retro feel to the game, which is kind of cool. You can just see by the pictures, the artwork. And your character gets perks, like special abilities, pretty much to enhance your ability to use weapons or to have more dialogue options when talking to NPCs. All right, I'll read the back to you. Prepare for the future. From the creators of the award-winning Oblivion comes Fallout 3. Featuring one of the most realized game worlds ever created. Create any kind of character you want and explore the open wastes of post-apocalyptic Washington, D.C. Every minute is a fight for survival as you encounter super mutants, ghouls, raiders, and other dangers of the wasteland. Winner Game of Show, 2008 winner, Best of E3 by IGN.com, Game Critics Award G8 winner, GameSpy Best of E3 2008. The Fallout 3 Collector's Edition includes the Fallout 3 game, plus Vault Boy bobblehead, a collectible 5-inch Vault Tech Vault Boy bobblehead, the lunchbox, a customized metal Vault Tech lunchbox, making a Fallout 3, a special video offering an inside look at Bethesda Game Studios and the team behind the game, Fallout 3 art book, a hardcover book featuring never-before-seen concept art and commentary from Bethesda Game Studios artists. It's a one-player game, 480p and 720p output. So, we are going to open this bad boy up. Take a look inside. See if I can open this fairly gently. course, we'd love to hear from any of you out there. Sorry, I should say from you. If you've played Fallout 3 and or New Vegas. So it's got this little insert. There you go, here's the lunchbox. Pretty cool. Prepare for the future. This Fallout Boy on the bottom. Besides. Let's see if we can open this up. So you just flip the closure. Looks like a regular lunchbox. This is pretty cool. Open it up. And there we have it. That in a minute. Looks like we have the making of Fallout 3. This must be the artwork book. Take a look at that. And of course, I don't hope he's not broken. Maybe he isn't. Bobblehead in the stand. So I'm not sure if he might have snapped off here. Maybe not. Okay, no, he's good. So, definitely very cool if you're a Fallout fan. See, he even likes ASMR. Don't you? So, there's the bobblehead. Now we'll just set him right there. Oh, really? You're not going to cooperate? A little curve. surface right there. Okay, it's not going to work. Alright, so we're just going to leave him there. He can chill. So that is it for the lunchbox. So we have the two video games. Making of Fallout 3. Just says VDSG holotape, historical video footage of the development and implementation of the project. Restricted, do not remove from the archival room. After usage, to avoid dust contamination, immediately place this holotape back within its sleeve. Vault 101 archive room. So it's pretty cool in the little details, almost to give it that, you know, immersive quality to it. And there's just the CD, the DVD that's in there. Here is the art book. I'm definitely not going to have time to page through everything, but just some artwork, some of the creatures. It's definitely pretty cool. Guns, weapons, concept art, things of that nature, some storyboard stuff, so definitely pretty cool. Maybe one day I'll go through it page by page, but it is copyright material, so I may not. But you know, if this is, you're into collecting art books and concept art and things like that for video games or movies, this is definitely you know, something worth having and collecting. It's pretty chock full of some great art. Wow, pretty cool. And it's interesting how they actually, you know, have to come up with concept art. I always thought that they just sat down and did it in the game, the software, with the 3D models. But, you know, I never fully realized. Well, I mean, nowadays I do, but years ago, I never knew that they came up with concept art first. All right, so we got the game. Basically the same description that I read to you on the back of the lunchbox. It says, the power of choice. Are you good or evil? Talk out your problems or just flash your plasma rifle. Blast them away with VATS. Rain, death, and destruction in an all-new cinematic combat presentation. Limitless freedom. Visit towns, battle through DC, or explore the wasteland in first or third person. So why don't we open this up. So we got the game itself and Fallout little survival guide. And just, it's pretty much the manual. So it tells you all about your perks, level 2, 4, 6, 8, this is good. So you can see all the perks in case you want to get an idea. It's like special abilities. In case you want to get an idea of your path, I guess, it's kind of cool. So you can see how far you can go. Tells you how to level up, combat, tells you about vets, stealth, hacking, lockpicking, crime and punishment, dialogue, bartering. So, that's Fallout 3. And I always enjoyed putting experience towards speech. More dialogue options. Let me know the kind of characters that you've played, how many times you've played. Hopefully they continue with Fallout 4. I can't imagine they wouldn't. I mean, it's such a huge success. Everybody loves the post-apocalyptic, well, not everybody, but you know, most people like the post-apocalyptic genre. All right, Fallout New Vegas. Okay, we got a little advertisement here for Doom 3. Another CD, of course, and the New Vegas manual. Doesn't say anything about perks. Well, it doesn't have any perks listed in here, so I'm not sure if there are any new perks. But it says in the back here for New Vegas, whether you're a seasoned explorer of the Mojave or playing the game for the first time, you will find there are more friends and enemies to make, more consequences to be responsible for, and more opportunities to live in glory or infamy throughout the wasteland. The choices you make will be as influential as ever. Enjoy your stay. The definitive compilation, the Ultimate Edition, includes all 4 mission expansion add-on packs: Dead Money, Honest Hearts, Old World Blues, and Lonesome Road, along with 2 additional DLC packs: Courier's Stash and Gunrunner's Arsenal. Each add-on pack also adds to the mountain of armaments already at your disposal. Beyond the Wasteland. New Vegas is more expansive than ever with the Sierra Madre Casino, Zion National Park, big empty research crate and a treacherous divide now open for the exploring. Room to grow. With each of the four main add-on packs, the maximum level cap is increased by 5, ultimately raising the ceiling to level 50. So, there we have it. Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas. So I'll be adding those to the rotation, and I'm actually going to play Fallout 3. It's going to be the next video after this one. So, thank you for watching. Again, love to hear from you if you play. And if you haven't, I highly recommend it. Yeah, that's really it. I think I covered pretty much everything. Don't think there's anything else I wanted to touch base on, talk about. I personally love the game. I love the post-apocalyptic setting. All the aspects of the game are pretty great. I have no qualms with it that I can remember. So, well, I guess that's it. Thanks as always for joining me, and see you in game. Take care. Cheers. Should add ASMR as a perk in Fallout 4. That'd be great. Don't ask me what it would do. Maybe make your enemies fall asleep.